Based on huge pressure from USA, modern PM Modi will have a round of discussion on F-16 proposal this week, which has been put off indefinitely. A call letter of invitation has gone to LM for a Mi project December beginning. It's expected that some other urgency deal will be worked out if F-16 deal is not through in this meeting. PMO is hell-bent on getting a frontline fleet of USA planes, which IAF is steadfastly refusing. Stiff resistance from IAF in favoring Rafale, technical aspect clearance has not been accorded by IAF for F-16 Block 70 in the files. IAF has rejected first Gripen E, MiG-35, F-18, then F-16. IAF has made it clear that it supports Rafale Mi for itself and Indian Navy is on board this plan. With this in future, it wishes just Super MKI and LCA if it's available on time. IAF clearly said it does not want SE planes at the cost of Rafale number curtailment under any circumstances. No clarity on any tangible technology for DRDO or private entity as of now. PMO insistence for pro-USA has burned our hands with few of our close allies. We are facing some challenges with UAV fleet with support from Israel facing some teething issues. One of the chief issue being support packages pricing and renewals. PMO is now looking at a big UAV fleet for all surveillance activities and strikes roles from the USA. There are talks of moving ISTAR-like systems to an unmanned fleet concepts as well. Same as Guardian be having new versions for ASW roles. Also, there is a confirmation that a high-altitude pseudo-satellite Zephyr is on offer with sufficient know-how for an Indian version. It's not given much weight owing to first USA relationship-leaning thinking. Currently DRDO team is there in France for Kavarian and tests as reported earlier. In the recent meeting between S. Christopher, CHM and DRDO and Secretary R&D DOD, with French officials like DM Parley, meeting with Pres Macron and senior management of Dassault in Paris, a certain discussion focused on fifth-gen plane and joint efforts. The discussion focused on many aspects and our decision-making changes regarding indigenous fifth-gen projects. It was mutually agreed that Rafale F4.2 and beyond standard technology will flow in DRDO-authorized units and DRAL ecosystem. The Rafale under such technological expertise will be just below the formal definition of fifth gen but accept the stealth shaping and reduced RCS. Most of the other technical fields will be outmatched with Rafale upgradation plan. There was also a talk on a dedicated electronic support version of Rafale in the lines of F-35 and increasing the stealth shaping and cancellation aspects using GanTech. A study for the same is planned as a way to upgrade the fleet via such technical upgrades. As of now, such a dedicated platform for ESV Rafale is not planned, but in future if a need arise, such a platform will be jointly manufactured. Also talks hovered around a certain light category aircraft platform where France has offered help and support. A quick note on all such technology sharing and systems for that aircraft was quickly pointed and jointly reviewed. Things seems to be on track. In the end, Pres Macron also added that all future Rafales will be made with certain percentage from Indian unit of DRAL components always. It may start with any of the Qatari or Egyptian follow-on orders if DRAL facility is ready with manufacturing. Super MKI deal will be green-lighted soon as IAF is looking at Rafale Super MKI combo. The radars, AMs and network-centric abilities will be given a big boost in Super MKI in order to perform a big role on future missions and communicate freely with Rafales. India has given a revert stating they plan to undertake all the portion of super upgrade in MKI facility of HAL. New Delhi made two more important disclosures. First, the super upgrade will have Israel as a technology consultant cum guide for all the whole project for upgrade. Second, an Indian private sector company will be part of this upgrade plan and will partner HAL for MKI upgrade. This Indian company will be the base company via which certain technologies will flow. It's expected to have a certain highest possible technology access from an American major Raytheon among some other entities for avionics and with Israeli companies for major systems, subsystems and French portions too. The 7th series production Tejas aircraft carried out its first maiden flight from HAL facility in Bangalore successfully this week. LCA Tejas SP-6 had completed its first flight in the month of July. Since then, HAL was not able to keep pace with scheduled delivery, and SP-5, which was first aircraft coming out of second production line, is yet to make its maiden flight due to technical glitches. HAL till now has delivered Tejas SP-1, SP-2, SP-3, SP-4 and SP-6, and was committed to deliver 6 more planes by end of March 2018. LSP-8 is optimizing flight profiles with the in-flight refueling probe. Air-to-air refueling trials will begin early 2018. First dry contact followed by wet trials. So far, LSP-8 flew 44 sorties with IFR. SP-9, SP-10 and SP-11 are already in various stages of the assembly, and HAL officials are confident that all 3 remaining aircraft will be transferred by end of March 2018, and last of the aircraft will complete its maiden trial by early March. 45 Squadron. The Flying Daggers of the IAF also recently successfully completed first simulated night attack demonstration of the aircraft, which was done to test the ability to carry out ground strikes in the cover of darkness. LCA Tejas has been given a strict deadline for FOC by December 18, failing which there will be a severe curtailment of future orders for HAL and its ecosystem. HAL products will be moved further into the private sector. LCA Mk-1A iteration is also given a deadline by mid of 2020, failing which Mk-1A program will be wound up. These deadlines have been given with extra time to ensure no more additional time is needed to be given.